We're looking at the main side quad, 5x3 back squats, and we're going to talk about a couple different components of this workout that you as an athlete might be thinking of when you see this appear on the main side. First off, 5x3, we're going for 3 reps, and what we're essentially trying to do is find a new 3 rep max. We want a PR, or at least come as close to our previous PRs as possible. One of the questions that I get a lot as a coach is, what kind of back squat is it? Is it a high bar back squat and a low bar back squat? So let's talk about those two different types of squats and the differences and how you can decipher between the two. So the first one, the high bar back squat, I'm gonna have Keith come in here and demo. What he's gonna do is he's gonna come underneath the bar, and a couple main differences. Number one, the bar now, it's resting on his traps on top of his scapula, and his hands are a little bit narrower, okay? This is a high bar back squat position, and he walks it out of the rack. And as he comes down now, he's got his feet generally a little bit narrower than he would if he was gonna do a low bar back squat. This is a back squat that's very transferable to the Olympic lift. So as Keith goes down, if he can just stop at the bottom for a second, burn him out with 135 pounds, he's got a pretty vertical torso here, okay? His shins are kind of canted forward a little bit, and he drives straight up. And he's also able to get a lot of depth as he goes down. The crease of his hip is way below his knee. So that's very transferable. You can rack it up. Very transferable to the Olympic lifts, things that we would see both in a front squat and an overhead squat, that really vertical torso and getting a lot of depth so we can go down and catch that bar in a really low position. One of the main differences here between the high bar back squat and the low bar back squat is the high bar back squat is a much more quad demanding back squat, okay? So we're way more on our quads and not as much into our glutes and our hamstrings, okay? With the low bar back squat, this is what we see a lot in powerlifting, where now he's got the bar right between his shoulder blades, kind of on the meat. And if you notice the difference here with his hands, his thumbs aren't wrapped around the bar, his hands are a little bit wider, and he drives his elbows up to kind of create that meaty shelf so he can walk it out. When he takes his stance, he can be a little bit wider now. And what he's gonna mainly concentrate on is sitting his butt as far back as he can. And you can see the difference here with his torso as it's canted forward about 45 degrees, okay? Out of the bottom of his squat, what he's doing is he's driving up, go ahead, stop at the bottom, he's driving up with the lower part of his back, getting some good hip drive, and then standing up, driving those knees back, versus the high bar back squat, where we're just a little bit more on the quads, and not so much into the hamstrings. And you can rack it up here. Which one is the right one? There's no answer. They're both right. It depends what you want to work on. If you want more transferability to the Olympic lifts, or that's something that you're interested in getting more mobility in the bottom of that squat and working on your vertical torso, then you might want to elect to do a high bar back squat. If you're just trying to move as much weight as you possibly can in a back squat while getting the crease of your hips slightly below your knee and lifting that maximal load, you'd probably want to go with a low bar back squat. But when I back squat, I generally try to do it in the low bar position because I really want to try and develop my hamstrings and my glutes and the posterior chain and all that. So I usually elect to go with that one. But neither one is more right than the other. They're both great exercises. And I'll leave you guys up to choose on your own which one you want to go after.
Thank you.